We did see $20 billion come in last year. Early part of this year, some outflows happened both in equities and on bond side. What's the sense that you're getting in the context of tapering having begun?
You know, one of the sense I get is that there are a lot of people who want to put a lot of money in India, provided we put our act together. We put our act together, we get our investment cycle right, we get our policy, this so-called decision-making process, which is, you know, for nothing can be resolved, you know, I mean, for sure, I mean, say that tax issues or, I mean, we are in all kinds of confusion. As a nation, we just can't take decisions and move forward.
That's holding back money, you're
That's
saying.
Clearly holding back money, because none of the infrastructure project can come, power, I mean, any of the controversies happen. I mean, in a country like this, there will be problems, but it has to be resolved. Resolved time-wise and in a definitive way. So we are not seeing that kind of a regime where you ask some question and it gets resolved one way or other very quickly. So if we get to that kind of situation, which is, that is the hope, I'm saying hope, that may come and you get a damn good government and everything starts falling in place.
Then you're seeing increased capital flows.
Huge can be. It can be very, very large capital flows despite tapering and all. I mean, there could be a gap of 6 months here and there. But the potential over a period of time to get attract capital into India is very, very large.
Brings me to the next question about, you know, we're talking in a time when inflation continues to be at elevated levels. Companies have pretty much factored in higher cost of capital through the course of the year. You're not going to get rate cuts. Where does that leave the currency? A large part of the conversation last year, I remember you were talking about the currency crisis, the current account deficit. Do you think for the new government that comes in, that the current account deficit and rupee is not so much of a headache?
Yeah. So, you know, one or two events which have shaped up, economic policies, or it will shape up economic policies, is one of the very important things which happened in the last 12 months is this currency crisis. Now, we were almost on the brink of touching 68, 70, and I mean, I think this government lost a lot of credibility because of the way the entire current account deficit and economic management
went out of hand
completely, right, and right. Currency went for free fall. So, clearly, they don't want to repeat that, and hence they've got the best guy possible in the world to take care of the monetary policy here.
Right.
So, that's one fantastic achievement of this government to put Rajan into the seat. And he knows his job, and I think he has done a wonderful job since he has come. Currency is already stabilized. He has already said that he's going to look at CPI, and that too more like 5%, 6% kind of thing. I don't know whether he's able to achieve that dream. But if that were to happen in the next 1 or 2 years, I think we are going to see a lot of consequent thing happening because of with the low inflation. We have not actually seen any low inflation, sustained low inflationary situation, except for a few years in 2003-04 at about 5%. We have not seen CPI at about 5% in last 25-30 years.
Sure.
So it has been very inflationary, more like double digits, you know,
sure.
8, 10, 12, 15 has been the order.
Sure.
Right now we are going through 9-10%. So if he's talking about 5-5.5% kind of a targeted CPI, And hence, you got to have the fiscal guy, finance minister, also responding to that particular need.
So you're in a good place.
I think irrespective of the government, even if it is third front, you are going to get that thing going right, because nobody wants to mess around with the rupee-dollar parity in a serious
way. You would think the rupee would be in this range?
I would think so. I mean, if the current account deficit has come down to more like less than $50 billion, less than 2-2.5% of GDP, and then now the only thing is to manage the second deficit, that is your current account deficit, and then address the growth.
Sure.
So I think that front, even this budget, Mr. Chidambaram numbers, despite there might be some issues here and there, but I think given the situation, it was quite, there's some method in the madness, irrespective of everything. So my sense is that I'm not that much worried about the rupee dollar at this juncture.